this was orchestrated before the foundations of the world. Can you imagine that? Before he said, let there be light, he knew that on the 21st of January 2018, you would be seated where you're sitting, and I would be standing where I'm standing, and he would be communing with us. How awesome is our God? First and foremost, I want to recognize our Father, the Father of the house, Bish. Can we give a mighty hand to Bish? Let's give a mighty hand. They are our mom and dad. They love us. They've been here for us. And I'm an old boy here. Mimi, nilianza kuja church nikiwa class 3, I think. Tulikuwa tunameet huko karibu na bathrooms, the ladies. Hapo karibu, there is a 3-piece that's there, I think. And that's where with Teacher Mercy, she's in the house. Chamasi taught us, and I grew up here. I went to Cornerstone Academy, and nikitoka hapa, this building was ilikuwa mbao. But now, praise the name of the Lord, it's amazing. It's an amazing sanctuary. Like Bishop has said, in 2014, I went to Indonesia. Australia. I went to Australia in 2014, where I studied theology. I did a diploma, I'm just an ordinary guy. Nikasoma my diploma in Christian ministry and theology. 2 years later, the Lord sent me all the way to Indonesia, and I have been there for the last 1 year, and we've been making disciples, we've been planting a church there, and I'm intending to go back next month after the 40 days of fasting. Amen. Sasa hizo zote chukua weke kando. Now let's get to the word of God. Amen. Let's pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you for gathering us here this morning. We thank you because you are with us. You say where two or three are gathered in your name, you're right there with them, O Lord. Father, cause us to be sensitive to your voice, O God. As I speak to your people, O God, Lord, may you whisper in their heart, Almighty Father. Father, let there be healing in this place. Let there be deliverance in this place. Let there be salvations won to your glory in this place, O God. Father, as I serve the bread of life, O God, let your sheep be fed. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Let's open Luke chapter 15. Luke chapter 15, I will read from verse 11 all the way to verse 24. Jesus continued, there was a man who had two sons. The younger one said to his father, Father, give me my share of the estate. So he divided his property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all he had, set off for a distant country, and there he squandered his wealth in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in that whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country who sent him to feed his pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. When he came to his senses, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have food to spare? And here I am starving to death. I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. So he got up and went to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. The son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his father, servants, quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring a fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. So they began to celebrate. Turn to your neighbor, say, I have a father. Turn to another person, tell them, I have a father. Now, touch yourself and say, I have a father. I have a father. Sema na ni kama una mini kenyu na sema. Say, I have a father. I have a father. I have a daddy. I have a papa. That's the topic for us today. Now, our Father in heaven, this is the kingdom, this is the year of kingdom manifestation, right? And the verse that we get that from is Matthew chapter 6, verse 10. And it says, thy will be done, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, right? But before that, it is the disciples who had asked Jesus, Jesus, teach us how to pray. And Jesus told them, when you pray, say this, our Father who art in heaven. So I don't know if you have had deep, bad experience about your earthly fathers, but we have a Father in heaven who is love. We have a Father in heaven who loves us no matter what we've done. His love for us is not dependent on us. His love for us is because He is love and He chooses to love us. It's not because of what you have done. It's not because of what you think about yourself. It's not because of what your neighbors think about you. But it is because He just loves you because He loves you because He loves you because He loves you. You know, there are a lot of people who are not going to depend on anything. You know, now the Lord is a million times more than that. Pray in the name of the Lord. He loves you. He loves you. He says, my child, I love you. He just loves you just for free. What is your feeling? Amen. He says, when we are still sinners, Christ died for us. Can you imagine that? When you were still a sinner, before you were even born, before you were a thought in His mind, He already died for you. 2,000 years ago. 2,000 years ago. But 2,000 years ago, before you even stepped foot on this earth, the Father loved you. The Father loved you. And He longed to have a relationship with you. He longed to have you in His presence. He longed to see your face glorifying His name. He longed to whisper sweet words to your mouth, to your ears. He longed to be with you. And that's why He made a way. He said, for me, so that I can be intimate with my son, Washigati, so that I can be intimate with my daughter, I'm going to do something. I'm going to sacrifice myself. I'm going to make a way. I want us to have a different view of the cross of Jesus Christ today. Most of the times, you hear about the cross, and sometimes we just cry, and oh, Jesus, you know, why did you have to do this for me? I'm so bad. Yesterday, nitakuja kanisa, I will cry. But tomorrow, I'll go back to my life. Jesus, did you really have to do this? You would have just let me be. And our worship to God becomes because we feel sorry for Jesus. Our worship to God becomes like we're feeling so bad, and our service to God is like now we are paying Him for what He did. No, this is not the way. Jesus did not die so that we can come and cry. Jesus died so that we can come to the Father and rejoice in Him. What is Jesus saying? Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. He did not say, I am the way to heaven. He said, I am the way to the Father. No one comes to the Father except through me. Jesus' death on the cross did not give you a free ticket to heaven. Jesus' death on the cross gave you an entrance into the Holy of Holies. That's why the curtains broke when Jesus healed your son. Praise the name of the Lord. A guy, I was reading a book called It Is Finished by David Wilkerson, and he said, the eternal separation from God that we deserved were taken up by God in God. That's powerful. The everlasting separation that we deserved was taken up by God in God. So God is spirit, right? God is spirit. God decided that I don't want to be separated from my children any longer. I want to be with my children. I want to have fellowship with my children. So God decided that I'm going to walk out of myself and put on flesh and walk among my children. And then I'm going to pay the price. I'm going to pay the price for their separation. I don't want to be separated with these people. I love them too much. I don't want them to be everlastingly separated from me. So I will separate myself from myself. And I'm going to come and I'm going to die for their sins. So that now on the cross I will say it is finished. And on the third day I will rise up again and say, behold, here I am. Peace be to you. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ came and said, peace be to you. Hallelujah. He came and said that the hostility that was between the Father and you because of your sin has now been paid for. The blood of the Lamb has already been poured upon the mercy seat. Now I can come and say, my son, here I am. You know, we are living in a time when Adam sinned against God. God came to the garden and asked, Adam, where are you? Adam, where are you? And Adam was hiding. I am hiding because I sinned against you, Lord. But now, God comes and says, Adam, here I am. When Jesus healed, there is nothing stopping you from having a relationship with God. There is nothing stopping you from having a real relationship with your Father. The Bible is a point, it's an arrow to point you to the Lord. It is not a list of do's and do nots. It's not a philosophy that when you apply in your life, it's going to work. It should lead you to a real relationship with the Creator of heaven and earth. He is real. Jesus is real. Jesus is real. When he's just healed, he's not an idea in our heads. He is not an idea in our hearts. He is real. He speaks, if only we would listen. Hallelujah. He wraps us in his arms, if only we would surrender. He shows us where to go, if only we would open up our eyes. Jesus is real. When he says, go turn to your neighbor, tell them, Jesus is real. Relationship with God is real. You know, my father died when I was 12 years old. We got class 7 at Cornerstone, and my earthly father died, and it was a big blow to our family. But praise God for the church, because the church was there for us. Now, when my father died, I became fatherless. That's usually what happens. And I was not only fatherless physically, I became fatherless mentally, emotionally. I was my own ruler. I did not have anybody to tell me, Lawrence, mtuana tabianga hivi, or Lawrence, mtuana baanga hivi, or Lawrence. There was nobody to guide me. There was no father figure. At 12 years old, that's when I'm beginning to become a man. Now the male figure in my life, Amanda. But I had one word from the Lord. In the Bible it says, he is the father to the fatherless. So I pursued him. I pursued him. Yes, nilikuwa na ile part ya fatherlessness, unruly, nikaenda, nikafanya. We don't want to glorify that because it's gone. All things have been made new. But I pursued the Lord. When he's just here, I pursued him. I said, if you're the father to the fatherless, I want to meet you. I want to talk to you the way I would talk to my father. Nikiwa na shida, nataka nikuje nikwambie dad. niko na exam na sina pesa kulipa exam na sijui kama unaweza nisaidia. I wanted a real relationship with my heavenly father. I wanted to go and ask him, Dad, kuna msichana nimeona na kuna vile nimeona kuna vyenye sijui kama unaweza nisaidia na mawaidha. I pursued the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I chased after him. I wanted to have a real relationship with him. I did not want my prayer life to be, oh, Father, bless your name, we need to have your name, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. No, I wanted to really talk to him.
Yes.
I wanted to really talk to him and to hear him talk to me back. So I pursued him. There was one time in Australia, and by the way, he's a rewarder of those who seek him diligently. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. For those who come to me must believe that I am, and I am a rewarder of them that seek me diligently. He said, seek me and you shall find me. Hallelujah. He said, seek me and you shall find me. Can you imagine that? The one who said, let there be light, na jua bado imewaka, hakuna mtu ashaizima KPLC, hawaizima hiyo. You know, he said, let there be light, and there is still light up to today. Hallelujah. And now he says, seek me and you shall find me. He comes and sits next to you and tells you of great and mighty things. Man, you have no idea how much it is a blessing for us to commune with the Father. This is what he wants. He created us for communion with him. Hallelujah. So anyway, I was in Australia and I took my friend. I used to pick him up from work. The Lord had blessed me with a car when he was here. And I took him from work. And on this day, I used to minister to this guy. And on this day, I told him, hey, let's go to the lakeside. Let's go and just sit there for a while. So, tukafanya drive-through, tukanunua McDonald's. And then we went to the lakeside. And I was just sharing with him. He told me that his father had also died a long time ago, so he did not have a father figure in his life. And I was like, ooh, those are the bells. That's it right there, you know. Now I can introduce you to the Father. And I started sharing with him about my Father in heaven. So it was winter time in Australia. My car was turned off, but during the winter, the heater was on. So the heater is on and I'm sharing about the Father's love. Tumekula chiko na bani, tumeboga jamako. What? It's true. He's like, wow, I really believe these things now. I was telling him about many testimonies of what the Lord had done in my life. And so, without knowing, time passed so quickly and we realized that it was late at night. So we come, okay, let's go back home. See you. So he started out. Because the heater was on, the battery of the car had died. So, nikauliza huko best yangu, kuna mtu anaweza pigia simu ama tuite mtu akuje atusaidie ku jump start gari, si ndio? And he said, "Eh, ni ngumu, sina mtu akupigia huko." And then I took out my phone. Everybody I looked at in my contacts. Wote walikuwa, you know, you cannot just randomly call somebody in the middle of the night and tell them, hey, nimekuwa ama lakeside, si ukuje ulikuwa muwe. You cannot just do that. People have lives, amen. So there was nobody to call. Kasema wacha tujaribu kitu tena. But then my car was an old 1994 Toyota hatchback. So, sio zile za kujirevive. Unajua, these days we have nice cars. These days, gari ikiishi unaweza iachia boda kakadha and then itawaka tena, si ndio? This one was a gone case. Ilikuwa, woo! And we had nobody to call. And then I asked him, if your father was here, he would come and jumpstart this car for you, si ndio? And he said yes. And I said, if my father was here too, he would come and jumpstart this car. But they are not here. And I have been telling you of our Father in heaven. We believe that everything is possible with him. So we decided, let's call our Father in heaven. One is a city. So We said a very honest prayer to God. I told him, "Where to be a maneno zako, muita vita to be a maneno zako, muita." I said, "Father, if our father was here, he would come and jumpstart our car. Now because you took him, we asked you to come and jumpstart our car." Immediately I felt faith rise up in my spirit. I asked the guy, "Ukoredi kwenda nyumbani?" He said, "Niko ready." I told him, "Put on the seatbelt." You know, faith is action. Put on the seatbelt. Akavaa seatbelt. Nikavaa yangu. Kacha. Nikashikilia hiyo kitu. The car started. Our father came down and jump-started our car. But this was the feeling. We serve a God who is real. We serve a God who hears us when we call. We serve a good Father. There is no place He will not take you out of. There is no hole He will not deliver you from. We serve a good Father. But this is your son. The Lord is good. Amen. The Lord is good. The Lord is good. Let's look at Romans chapter 8 verse 15. Romans chapter 8 verse 15. I love Romans chapter 8. Kama hujaisoma Romans chapter 8, that's your homework. Go and read Romans chapter 8. It's an amazing book. Romans chapter 8 and verse 15 says, "The spirit you received does not make you slaves again. Slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, Abba, Father." Hallelujah. It says, "For you did not receive a spirit that makes you a slave again to fear. But you receive the spirit of sonship, and by him we cry, Abba, Father." So, when you're walking around Zimmerman in the middle of the night, the spirit you receive does not make you a slave again to fear. Unaogopa sijui nani atakuja kukore. But the spirit you receive gives you adoption into sonship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The term adoption, it's also in Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 to 6. Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 to 6. Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 to 6. It says, "But when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law," that's us, we were under the law, "that we might receive the adoption as sons," verse 6. "And because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son into your heart, crying out, Abba, Father. This is the mystery, that we are no longer just servants of God. We are no longer just creation of God, but we are sons of God." Hallelujah. We are sons of God. We have been adopted. The Greek term, adoption into sonship, the Greek term is huiothesia. Huiothesia, kama unaandika ni H-U-I-O, alafu verses, but kumisha unaandika A. Huiothesia. Huiothesia is actually, it's actually a legal term. A legal term that you become legally somebody's son with all the rights, with everything that comes with that. If you are legally a son of God, you are legally, you're not illegal. We are not Israelites, so sometimes we might feel like we're illegal, and we might feel like we have to like pester God and like really pray hard because we are not children. We are children of Abraham. We are sons of God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe, because we have been adopted into sonship. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. The root words are two. There is tithemi, which means to be placed, and huios, which means child. That's the root word of that. So you have been placed as a child. So you are taken from wherever you are. All by him, it's not because of what you did. All by his grace. He took you and he says, "Sasa wewe nitakuchukua." It's like going to a children's home and looking at a random baby and deciding, "I'm going to adopt this child. I'm going to become my children. That's exactly what happened. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth, came and saw you and decided, I'm going to take you to be my child. I'm going to take you to be my child. So you are a prince. So you are a princess in the kingdom of our Lord. In this kingdom, in this year of kingdom manifestation, let this be a truth in your life. Princesses and princes do not beg for bread. Why should you beg for bread? Hallelujah. When they are sick, when we are sick, you know, this is even a higher level. When you're sick, the Spirit of the Lord quickens our mortal bodies. Hallelujah. The Spirit of sonship, the Spirit of God quickens our mortal bodies and we become healed on SSCPA. So let this be a reality in your life. Everywhere you go, let this be a reality. Let it be manifested upon you. Hallelujah. And Nikimaliza, let's go back to the prodigal son. In 15, Luke chapter 15, verse 14, he says, after he spent everything, there was a severe famine in that land. I would invite the worship team to come, maybe. Thank you. He says, after he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in that home country, and he began to be in need. I don't know how many of us here are in need of something. We are all here. There is nobody who can say, I am full. Nobody can say, I am complete. We are all here because we are in need of something. And when this young man began to be in need, he decided, I am going to go to my father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whatever it is you're in need of, you will not find it anywhere else. The Bible says that there was no one to help this young man. There was absolutely nobody to help this young man. When he began to be in need, let me tell you something, brother and sister. The doctors cannot help you. Your neighbors cannot help you. Your relatives cannot help you. Your help is with your father. Your father has what you need. So this young man decided, I will go to my father. Hallelujah. He decided, I'm going to get up and go to my father. In Luke chapter 15, verse 20. So he got up and went to his father. Today, I don't know what it is that you're in need of. I don't know what it is that you're crying out for. Today, I'm here to encourage you. Get up and go to your father. Get up and go to your father. Get up and go to your father. Because you will find provision with your father. You will find your healing where your father is. You will find deliverance where your father is. You will find righteousness, those who hunger and thirst, for you shall be filled. Rise up and go to your father. There is nothing else in this world that will satisfy you. There is nothing that will satisfy that thirst. There is nothing that will satisfy your heart. Get up and go to your father. Get up and go to your father. Get up and go to your father. There is nobody else in this world who can help you. Nobody else can help you. Get up and go to your father. And look at what happened when this guy got up and went to his father. When he was still afar off. When he was still afar off, the father saw him coming. The father saw him coming with tattered clothes. The father saw him coming with all his guilt carried upon him. The father saw him coming with all the sicknesses. The father saw him coming to him. And the father decided, I'm going to go and meet my son. I'm going to go and meet my daughter. I will run towards my son. He says, draw near to me and I shall draw near to you. Today, when you rise up going to your father, I'm here to announce to you that he will meet you in the middle of the way. He shall meet you in the middle of the way. He shall meet you with your provision. He shall meet you with your healing. There is nothing too hard for him. shall meet you on the way. For your ministry, he shall meet you on the way. For your business, he shall meet you on the way. Rise up and go to your father. What is blessing you? Rise up and go to your father. He's waiting for you. He's been waiting for you. He's been watching to see if my son is coming. And when he sees you coming from afar, he's going to run towards you. He's going to embrace you in his arms. He's going to clothe you with a robe of righteousness. He's going to put a ring on your finger and sandals on your feet. It doesn't matter what you're wearing, the Father will embrace you. It doesn't matter what you look like, the Father will embrace you. He's not embarrassed by you because he loves you. Because he loves you. He calls you my beloved. He paid a dear price to be with you on the cross at Calvary. All your bills were paid. Arise and go to your Father. Arise and go to your Father. Let us stand on our feet. The Father is here this morning, and he wants to meet you. And he wants to meet you. Oh, Jesus. Lift up your voice and then start worshiping him. Lift up your voices and start telling him what you're in need of. Lift up your voices and start going towards your Father. He's here. He's here to meet you. 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 He's running towards you right now. He's running towards you right now. Oh, kare okoto yanda. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your presence in this place. Your children are coming back to you. Your sons and daughters are coming back to you. Your sons and daughters are coming back to you, mighty Father. Your sons and daughters are coming back to you. Your sons and daughters are coming back to you. Arise, O Lord. Arise, O Lord. Arise, O Lord. The Father is here today. Your father is here today. He knows your name. He knows what you've been going through. He knows the desires of your heart. He says, today come to me, child. He says, today come to me, child. He says, today come to me, child. He is here. I want to give this chance to you. If you want to give your life to Jesus, just pick your hand up. Just lift up your hand and say, yes, I want the King of Glory to be my Father. Lift your hand up and say, today, yes, I want to have a real relationship with the Father. He says your guilt is nothing to him. He says your unforgiveness is nothing to him. He says your wrongs are nothing to him. I'll give you one more chance. Put your hand up if you want to give your life to Jesus.
Receive it to thanksgiving.